want to go and make history in Tokyo. We are training nearest the two facilities, the Kiprotich Training Center, and then my training center.
He's exceptional talented.
It's Joshua Cheptegei, a Ugandan.
So many individuals, both young and old, they look up to me. Always believe in yourself, believe in your capabilities, and believe in your dreams. It shall come to pass that one day you'll achieve it and you'll walk in it.
Someone will not go in where he's not going to get anything. That's the most important thing that the government and the people of Uganda should do. Should know is that they are very proud when these boys win, when these girls win. Everyone in Uganda is excited and proud. Hey, but they deserve their what? The benefits.
Olympic Games is just 7 months away from now, and we are laying a foundation and we have started training, and we hope that we can do best as a country, as an individual. Also, I believe that I have goals to chase for 2021. I don't want to miss out on the gold medal of the Olympic Games, and we are really doing well.
There is time enough, and we need some time to build up slowly.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, with the help of our coach Adi Ruita, with the help of Global Sports Communication, we believe that we will do something amazing.
We are going to do our best to do with the management of Global Sports and Uganda Athletic Federation, with our club, to see that we do what is really required, what is necessary for our athletes to win in the Olympics. So that's where actually my focus is now.
But in case of anything, I'll let Ugandans know about it. It requires a lot of tough training, mentally, and also putting into miles and speed. And I know I have the right coach who can really, who knows how to bring me at the right level at the right moment.
I know him. He's actually going to be much more motivated out of this. His attitude, he has been a very focused athlete, a very disciplined athlete, so I know it's going to change his mindset to do something much more different, because his running is a little bit quite different from others.
Talent enough in Uganda, and yeah, when the team around the athlete is very well organized, then that can be the result.
Cheptegei is not a person who gives up. Cheptegei is a man, when I look at him, he's so aggressive in running. He never let anything go. And that is the kind of spirit I love in him. And I know in Olympics he will say no. I can't let things go.
What a finish here, side by side. Who's got the heart? Who's got the belief? Who's got the hundreds and hundreds of miles in their legs? And the answer to that question, for the first time in history, it's Joshua Cheptegei, a Ugandan, becomes the world champion over 10,000 meters, Yomif Kajelcha the silver, and the teenager Ronex Kipruto takes the bronze, and he will be the toast of Uganda tonight.
There is no secret. It's a lot of things together. A good program, good structure. I'm not only a coach that is making a good schedule or a schedule, but you learn them also how to live as an athlete, how to live as a top athlete. And you are that for 24 hours a day. And that day after day, week after week, month after month, year after year. And then you can see the results are coming.
The world record is on.
11:35 at the bell there, a 59.9. He's covered his last three laps in almost exactly 3 minutes. He's matching stride for stride the closing pace of Kenenisa Bekele, but he set up this world record because he went out through the first half of the race and more, much quicker than the Ethiopian 16 years ago. Down the back straight, 250 meters to run, history in the making. Julian Vonders there of Switzerland waving him on is being lapped now, and hardly surprising, great runners will be lapped by this man as he goes into the final 200 meters. Still looking strong, no panic, no sign of stress, not driving hard. He's got to hit the clock, hit the line in 12:37.35. Is he going to do it? Because he's tiring now down the home straight. Surely it's going to be close. Watch the clock, 10 seconds to go. He's got about 50 meters to run and he's still driving for the line. At last he grimaces and looks mortal. But there, 12:35.37. The world record has been broken by almost exactly 2 seconds. And he's still smiling. He's still in good shape. This fella, well, probably deserves the name Superman beside his own Joshua Cheptegei of Uganda, more than anybody in the history of distance running in the modern era.
When I was in National Council of Sports, the government had a stipend that they promised athletes that when you win a gold medal, you're going to benefit from some money monthly. They call it, I think, stipend. But it is not forthcoming.
Sometimes most of the things when promised, sometimes it defines us that we are not having the right time to follow up, because now we have been having several competitions throughout the calendar year. So it makes things difficult for us to follow up, because we are not supposed to be in Kampala, we are supposed to be on the training base. Like also most of the things that were pledged by government individually, maybe to Alima, to me and other athletes, it makes for us difficult to go to Okela House, State House to go and follow up on those things, because we are supposed to be on training. So they just make things difficult for us.
I don't know whether it's also bureaucracy within the ministry. There's commitment by the president and the government, but whoever is sitting on it, I don't know. Because you find these athletes are complaining. And nobody is coming. You know, government, the way it works, nobody is following up these athletes to find out whether they are getting their benefits.
They are not.
Nobody is following them.
If you don't want to fulfill, don't promise.
So I would like to urge the government to... They have a good policy. They need to follow it up and ensure it is implemented. Because it's someone who has his own opinion. Maybe he doesn't want to help people. You know, the athletes are people from the village. Now, when they come to limelight, they may not know where to go for to look for the money. Those ministries are complicated. They may not know how to go there.
Some people may take advantage.
Yeah, people take advantage, and they take away the money from them. So I think government needs to really bring a policy that is clearly implemented, so that this young people, when he wins and he has a right of a benefit, he's given. He gets it in his account, not to go looking around for money. That money should come direct to his account and should be prompt, like any other salary.
Joshua Cheptegei is poised and ready for his assault on history. The reigning world champion, the world cross-country champion. And what a fantastic record he took from Kenenisa Bekele in August, over 5,000 metres. He'll be following the familiar figure of Roy Kruijtvenk,
his job to do the early pacemaking duties. This is really good from Roy. He's going to have to answer some savage questions. I was talking to his coach, Adi Ruta, and he was saying that Joshua has a massive appetite for pain. He says, I don't really need to equip him with any mental tools to try and cope with the pain. He's just born with a gift to take punishment, and that's what he's going to need to be able to do tonight. Matt Ramsden's done a good job here. 7:52. They are absolutely bang on world record pace at the moment. He needs Nicholas to keep going as long as he possibly can. This is the loneliness now of the long distance runner. Cheptegei is now on his own. He's being roared on though by a growing number of people sitting on the city wall. And you know what, I just noticed a little almost imperceptible acceleration there, because I think he sensed that this is getting a little bit tight. It's a glittering list of who's who in terms of the all-time greats, and that's the kind of company that Joshua Cheptegei would be in if he can somehow keep this going. This is absolutely incredible. Wherever you're watching this in the world, I hope you're enjoying this, because we're watching something really, really special here. 62.9, lap after lap after lap. He's edging ever closer to a place in the history books. He is standing as a symbol of all that is great. He's pouring his heart and soul into this record attempt, into this journey to greatness that he is relentlessly pursuing. He's just got to keep driving. Kenenisa Bekele's time, 26.17. We've seen one world record. I think we might be about to see another. This has been absolutely fantastic. The hairs on the back of my neck are standing to attention. It's a standing ovation from everyone here. He has roared with the heart of an African lion. He's delivered. It's a world record for Joshua Cheptegei, the Commonwealth champion, the world champion, is the fastest man in history, over 6.25 miles. And this is a night that will never be forgotten.